Hey guys, welcome back to my channel. So today I wanted to film another tutorial using the very affordable Emily Edit the Wants palette in collaboration with Makeup Revolution. I will link down below my other video that I did with more of a like purpley violet shade on the lid. Totally different now. We're going on the green side. I know somebody mentioned wanted to see a green tutorial, so we got some greens in here, so let's do it. I will list down in my description bar that video in case you guys wanted to see that, and as well as hear a little bit more about the palette and you know how happy and excited I was that Emily did this collaboration. Super duper excited for this palette. I love it. If you guys haven't picked it up, it keeps going out of stock at Ulta, so definitely once you see it, you know, in stock, try to pick it up. And if you're lucky, maybe try to pick it up at your local Ulta store if you see it as well. But just if you guys want to see this video using some affordable products, then definitely keep on watching. Hey guys, so I've already primed my eyes and I'm starting off with my favorite transition shade, Midwest. I love this color. It's a nice sweep of color, or you can even intensify it with a denser brush, but I'm just using my Sonia Kashuk fluffy brush and just adding that all around as just like a nice warm brown transition. Then I'm gonna go back into the palette and I'm gonna take that shade Prayer, which is just a little bit cooler tone. It's like a nice like hint of kind of like mauve in there. I really like this shade, so I'm just gonna add this closer to the crease just to add that nice transition, a little bit more dimension, give that nice brownness before we go into the color. And then just really quick, going back in with that fluffy brush and just blending both two shades together. The key here is going to be blending, taking your time, and blending with clean brushes, of course. Then I'm going to go into the shade Corduroy, which is this very like a deep green shade. And here you definitely want to take your time. I'm going in with, I think this is a Sigma E25 brush. And this one I'm putting in even lower into the crease. And it's totally okay if it falls somewhere onto the lid, because we're going to clean that up and we're going to just put a totally different color there. And just building this color up to the intensity that I want, and blending. That's the key here with this shade especially, is building but blending while you build that shade. So taking my time and really trying to blend it out here, because that'll just save you some time in general when you add more colors and just trying to blend those out. So little by little. Then we're gonna go in to the shade Dark and Early. So it's a matte black shade. I'm just adding that to the outer corner of my eye. So this is really just gonna help me smoke out that look. Just patting that in and blending as well. However, darker ones and blending out as we pat that color in and just, you know, get it to the satisfaction that we want. Going in with my concealer, and now here I'm carving out the lid and just cleaning everything up in preparation for the shade I'm going to add there. So definitely just take your time, and this will really help you if you want that like a nice precise cut crease. And here I'm just using the concealer that I'll be using later for underneath my eyes, so just make sure it's a nice pigmented shade. It's not like a super duper lightweight concealer, because then it's not going to do much. So make sure it has some sort of pigment. Going back into the palette, I'm taking the shade Grateful, which is a really nice, light, almost minty green, nice little brightness. And there I'm just like, ooh, that's nice. I really like the shimmer shades in this palette. So I'm taking this and patting it into like the inner third of my eye, almost like kind of half of what I kind of carved out. And then we're gonna later go in with a deeper color and add that transition of a darker shade, but just getting that intensity that I want on the shade. You can totally do the whole lid, but I wanted to use, you know, a couple of other colors today. So I'm gonna take that shade, it's like a mossy green called Side Hustle, a little bit deeper, not as bright, and this I'm gonna bring into the rest of my lid and kind of blend that in to the Grateful shade, as well as the dark matte black and the matte green Corduroy. So just take your time and blend those and really try to get like a nice little transition between the Grateful and the Side Hustle, and kind of give it a nice, easy, even transition. going back in with just a little bit of corduroy and just blending my lid shade and my crease shades together. And just kind of, you know, if you lost a little bit or you want to add a little bit, you know, above in the crease to make that kind of corduroy shade stand out, especially when you kind of add a lid shade, you can use that, lose that color. I'll go ahead and take the opportunity and do that. To overall blend, just taking a completely clean brush, this is a Sigma E25, and just doing a nice light blend all together of like mostly the corduroy shade and then as well as Prayer and Midwest. Taking my Makeup Revolution Fast Base Foundation, I just did a review and demo on this one if you guys are interested. This is their stick foundation. And I'm taking my Wet n Wild stippling brush, my favorite brush for stick foundations and even like maybe lighter weight, really glowy foundations. I think this is a great, great brush. If you guys have not bought it, I mention it in like a lot of videos. Totally worth the money. This is really great to help kind of really kind of press stick foundations, you know, help them melt and like press them into the skin. So that's where I really like it, and just makes the transition even easier. So I'm just going in and blending that foundation shade in, and this one is in the shade F10, in case you guys are curious, but I'll link down below the video for my full review and demo in case you guys are curious or if you missed it. Taking the Makeup Revolution Fast Base Concealer, next will be my review and demo on this concealer if you guys are curious. But I'm going in, this is the shade F4. I really wanted F5, but they didn't have it online. And I really wanted to test it out. But I have an F4 in general that I've used for the Conceal and Define Concealer. So I was like, we'll go ahead and this will be like, you know, my regular shade when, you know, my tan kind of fades. But regardless, I feel like it kind of worked out for this video anyway. Just blending that out with my Beauty Blender and just stay tuned for when that review comes out. Going in with my LA Colors Highlight and Contour Palette and just patting that in to set my concealer. And this has a nice little pigmentation, so if you want to brighten underneath the eyes, you can totally do that as well. I love this palette so much. It was like $6 or $7, maybe even $5. I got it at Family Dollar. That's how cheap it is. I love it, and I wanted to pull it out for this video, especially since, you know, I love to use very affordable products. Going in with my NYX Micro Brow Pencil, and I'm gonna go ahead and I'm just doing my brows. That I'd show you a little sneak peek of, you know, what my regular brows look like and what you can really make your brows into with a really affordable pencil. And just, you know, kind of taking your time, some practice, you can do it. Then going in with my NYX Matte and Liquid Liner, and I'm gonna go ahead and do my wing. Definitely we're going dramatic with the eyes, so we're going a little bit dramatic with the wing as well. Might as well have some fun. If you do a halo eye, I think you can totally skip the wing. Just do some really dramatic lashes. Going in with my L'Oreal Voluminous Smoldering Kohl Pencil, I'm just adding a little bit of black on my lower lash line, my waterline, and my upper lash line, just so you don't kind of see that peeking through for my false lashes. Going back in with the shade Corduroy, and I'm just going to add that to my lower lash line just to kind of add a little bit of green, bring everything together. You can totally do green, or there's just so many colors in this palette. You can really mix it up and go in maybe even with one of their burgundies, a purple, anything of your choice, and really mix it up. Going in with a little bit of that Grateful shade and just kind of bringing that into the inner third of the eye just to kind of brighten up there. And you can go full out with the corduroy, but I just wanted to add a little bit of shimmer. Going in with that brush that I use corduroy, no additional product, and just kind of blending out my lower lash line. And then I'm taking the shade Darken Early with a flat shader brush and just kind of adding it to the outer third of my eye and just kind of smoking it out there. We love dimension here. So one more time, going in with that pencil brush and mixing, or rather blending, that Darken Early shade out. Then I always like to go to the top of my lid and just intensify in case it wasn't intense enough for you. Let's intensify it even more. Taking my Milani Prep Set and Glow Powder and just setting my face with a dual fiber brush, just so that in preparation for bronzer, blush, and highlight. And I'm going to go back into that LA Colors bronzer and highlight, bronzer contour and highlight palette, and I'm just going to warm up the face a bit and add
like I said, more dimension. This is like the dimension eyeshadow or makeup tutorial. But I mean, hey, that's what makeup does. It gives you the ability to really switch things up. You can kind of, I love that you can just change the shape of your kind of like facial features, maybe eyelids and just all that. You can really just do some amazing things with makeup. That's why I love it. So much fun. Going in with a little bit of that highlight powder and just kind of carving out my contour and kind of cleaning it up. If you ever feel like you went a little bit lower than usual, you can go ahead and do that. And I'm taking my LA Girl blush in the shade Natural. I decided to switch it up from the usual coral shade and add a little bit of pink here and using another affordable option. And I'm actually using my Wet n Wild blush brush, another affordable option for you guys. Then blending everything together with my dual fiber brush in preparation for my highlights, and you know, just in case, making sure we don't have harsh lines around the face, neither nor do we want them on the eyes. Taking my Wet n Wild Mega Glow highlight in the shade Precious Petals, and I'm just gonna add that onto my cheekbones. Since this isn't like you can totally go gold, but I kind of want something not too gold, not too pink. So I think this is a nice, it goes well with the blush, and also it kind of like, I think ties in well with the eyeshadow. Gonna go ahead and take that down the Cupid's bow and the bridge of the nose to highlight. Then I'm gonna take a little bit on a smaller brush and I'm gonna add that to my inner corner highlight. You can totally use one of these shades from the palette, which I think Oh Heavens would have been a great option as well. But you know, I was like, either you can use an eyeshadow, or sometimes this is where I like to tie in my highlight from around the face. I like to take it in the inner corners and as well as underneath the brow bone, just so everything's a little bit more cohesive. Then for my lips, I'm going to take my Rimmel, one of my favorite lip liners, in the shade Epic. I think this is a great color for everybody. You can really enjoy this color. I'm a little sad that they're not selling a Rimmel products at Ulta. I wonder why. I don't know. I still see them at Walgreens, so I just found that really, really interesting. I don't know. Just wondering. Then I'm going to go ahead and take my Maybelline Matte Lipsticks, their nude collection, in the shade Beige Babe. It's normally a really, really light shade, but with a lip liner like this is how I like to kind of lighten it up and mix it up a bit and just kind of change up the color. Love the combination. That is a completed look. I hope you guys enjoyed this video. I will say, choosing a lipstick as always was challenging, but I think whatever lipstick shade you choose for this eye look, I think can really change it up and really make it your own. I hope you guys enjoyed this really colorful look, and hopefully maybe you will step outside the box with me as well.
I hope you guys enjoyed that tutorial, especially for those of you who want to play with some more color. I really like how this green look came out super easy. I feel like any kind of color scheme type of look you want to do with any kind of color in this palette, it's almost like it's already kind of set up for you, where it's like you got your darker, deeper transitions, but you can also really mix it up with some other colors and really create some more out of the box looks. But kind of had all those green options here for me. Can definitely do some different things. You can do a halo eye, whatever you please. If you guys end up recreating this look, please feel free to tag me on Instagram so I can, you know, definitely check it out and share it as well. I think those are always fun and exciting. But if you guys want to see some more tutorials with some more affordable products, make sure to comment down below so I can keep those coming for you guys. Thank you guys so much for watching. As always, don't forget to subscribe so you can get those notifications whenever I upload. Trying to really get some videos out for you guys, get that consistency, keep the excitement, keep things going here on the channel. So I hope you guys appreciate it. But make sure to come back and make sure to, you know, leave some comments and let me know what other types of videos you guys want to see, or what are your favorite types of videos, so I can continue to create those for you. Thank you so much, and I'll see you guys next time.